All right, let's move on now to another issue. The recently concluded barangay and sangguniang kabataan elections. Of course, win or lose, they need to submit their SOCE. So, kamusta naman ang ating mga kandidato pagdating sa SOCE submissions?
The usual Filipino attitude, ma'am. Until November 29, yung submission ng SOCE natin. And until today, wala pa pong mga 15% man lang yung nagsasubmit ng SOCE sa buong bansa. And of course, some of the candidates will be waiting for the last day to submit the statement of contribution and expenditure. But this is a warning to all those who ran in the last election. If you run in 2018 and you did not submit the SOCE, and at the same time, you run in 2022 and again, you did not submit the SOCE, in the case of Joel Maturan versus the Commission of Election, the Supreme Court said failure to submit SOCE in two consecutive elections will mean perpetual disqualification to hold public office, whether elective or appointee. Failure to submit SOCE once, there will be an administrative sanction to be imposed against the candidates who failed to submit the SOCE for 2023.
But do they know this? I mean, it's quite serious. Perpetual disqualification.
Yeah, I hope so, ma'am. That's why using your program as the platform, then we would like to inform again, reiterate to everyone, submit the SOCE. If it is your second time, you will not be even be appointed to a particular position, even a clerical position in the government. After the non-submission of the two SOCE.
Okay. Now, on another issue, the Comelec is also set to release within the week its legal opinion on who should govern Maguindanao del Norte and Maguindanao del Sur. So, iba pang complication. I wanted to ask you that. Let's move on to this and how it matters to the region.
Actually, Ma'am Karen, that's a very complicated issue. But as far as the Comelec is concerned, since Ma'am, tapos na po yung role namin, our role really was to conduct the plebiscite dividing the mother province of Mindanao into north and south. Tapos na po yung role namin as to who should sit. It should now be the role of the local government, of the Department of Interior and local government.
Mm-hmm. At ngayon ba na decision na yon?
Well, ngayon po ma'am, na-desisyon na kung sino, kung sino nakaupo, may in-appoint po kasi ang presidente doon sa Northern Maguindanao na, and doon sa isa naman sa South, kung sino yung incumbent na governor ng mother Maguindanao should be the one to sit as governor. So, ang complicated na issue lang dyan ma'am, yung sa governor of Northern Maguindanao.
Yes.
Somebody was appointed and then the vice governor of the original Maguindanao is now claiming that she should be the governor. That should be resolved not by the commission election. We do not have any call on that matter. It will be resolved by the Department of Interior and Local Government. And definitely it will be resolved by the courts later
on. But then for the next elections, a year from now, you'll have candidates coming for both of these areas, correct?
Yes, ma'am. And what is problematic, and of course we are preparing for that, is that this is the first time also, Ma'am Karen, aside from the one that you cited, this is the first time that we're going to elect the members of the parliament in the Bangsamoro. You remember, ma'am,
yes.
The members of the parliament are in transition as of this time, and therefore we will be electing the members of the parliament, aside from the fact on the issue of Maguindanao.
Okay. All right. Anything you'd like to add before we go, sir?
Well, I would like to clarify again, there is no more election by December 9. And as of the payment of our honoraria, we are now almost 90% in the payment of honoraria for our teachers. And again, would like
pero to... Pero ito yung sa nakaraang ano, yung honoraria na to, sa nakaraang barangay and SK.
Ito, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So magkano na, sir, nabigay nyo?
Almost 90%. And again, we increased that from 6,000 for chairperson to 10,000 and 5,000 for members to 9,000. So kahit na medyo may tax pa rin po because they were not exempt from taxation, at least we increased their honorary. And again, we'd like to thank everyone and we're hoping that to be able to implement more voting nationwide by next election. And hopefully the early voting hours will be likewise implemented nationwide.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you for joining me today, sir. Comelec Chairman George Garcia. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Karen.